प्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि सम्रम निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संपृक्तौ वागर्थ प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षर समाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च वर्णतोऽस्मिन्नित्रयम् धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्स्वपन्तादिर्धातुर्ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्म विचारसारपरमाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनी वीणापुस्तकधारिणी अभयदां चाढ्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां गत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। ओके, सो वी आर लुकिंग एट इको एनर्जी। सो दिस सूत्र I'm sorry. So Iko Yanachi, this sutra says Ikaha, Ikaha Stane Yan, Ikaha Yan Achi. Sorry, I'm used to writing since so anyway I don't need to write much here. Ikaha Yan Achi, it's all here. Forget that I'm using Medhaji's book. So this has everything, I don't have to write much. So what I'll do is that I'll maybe shift it to highlight. Let's see, highlight. So maybe this would be better. Let's see. So Ikaha Yanachi. So Ikaha Yanachi. Samhita Mishe. So Anuvritti Samhitayam. When samhita is there, then ikaha stane, as we saw stane, stane word will be used. Ikaha stane yan iti adesha bhavati. What does the vritti say? Lagu vritti says ikaha stane yan syat. Achi. So this much is the sutra. Shashti sthane yoga, by that ikaha stane, then yan syat. Yan pratyahara is a replacement for ik when ach follows. Achi. Achi pare parasaptami samhitayam vishaye. When samhitayam vishaye. Vishaye is pullinga shabda. So what we say is vishaye saptami. So this saptami samhita is in vishaye saptami. But since vishaye is nitya pullinga, samhita is nitya strilinga, you cannot change them. You cannot change the linga of either of the words. So when you say Vishaya Saptami here, I would say Vishaye. Vishaye Samhitayam Vishaye. So Vishaye means Vishaya Saptami. Then when Samhita Sandhi takes place, then between what and what? Between Ik, Ik Antargata Akshara and Ach Antargata Akshara, meaning Ik, one of the Ik letters, E, U, Ri, Ru, followed by any vowel, then the general rule is that Yan is the Adesha. Yavar Ala. Then which should be the adesha among yavar ala for e u ri ru? So that is expecting more paribhasha sutras, which we have seen, but there is no recording for these. I have recorded only one class. The earlier two had a loss of recording. There were only some 30 minutes recording or something. So anyway, these sutras are going to be covered as we have started lagu proper now. So shashti sthane yoga is one paribhasha sutra, whereby we have got this sthane shabda in the vritti, lagu vritti. So sthane, why? Because it has come from this shashti sthane yoga. Whenever there is shashti prayoga, then sthane yoga. So sthane yoga is vidheya. So what is said is sthane iti padena yogaha yasyaha sa sthane yoga. So what is said is the lagu vritti says anirdharita sambandha vishesha shashti sthane yoga bodhya. So when you have this shashti in the sutra, there the sthane shabda can be added, which will indicate that in whatever word in this shakti will become the sthani and take the adesha ordained by the first case. Another, say all these sutras we have seen, but then these are needed to interpret the अच्छंदी स्तोत्र इको यणची. सो वॉट इज डन इज दैट दीज आर कवर्ड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम सो दैट वंस वन सूत्र इज अंडरस्टूड अंटिल यू नीड अनदर पारिभाषिक सूत्र दीज विल नॉट बी कवर्ड अगेन. सो तस्मिन इति निर्दिष्टे पूर्वस्य तस्मिन. सो तस्मिन इति निर्दिष्टे पूर्वस्य तस्मिन इज सप्तमी. सो व्हेन देयर इज अ सप्तमी बाय इति, सिंस इति इज सेड, इति मीन्स व्हेन तस्मिन मीनिंग एनीथिंग इन द सेवेंथ केस इज यूज इन द सूत्र देन निर्दिष्टे व्हाट विल हैपन पूर्वस्य. पूर्वस्य पूर्व विल बी द स्थानी आदेश पूर्वस्य भवति. सप्तमी निर्देशेन विधीयमानं कार्यं वर्णांतरेण अव्यवहितस्य पूर्वस्य बोध्यम्. वी हैव सीन दिस. सो व्हेनेवर यू हैव सप्तमी, व्हाट इज द सप्तमी देयर? अचि. इन द सूत्र दैट वी आर लुकिंग एट देयर सप्तमी अचि इज देयर. सो इकः इकः यण अचि. सो अचि इज सप्तमी देयर. सो व्हाट इज सेड, दिस अचि शब्द इन इको यण अचि, दैट अचि is understood as the ikahyanchi. So by seventh case, what precedes immediately precedes what is immediately purva, what precedes immediately is to be considered as the sthani. So the karya has to be immediately purva to what is in the seventh case. What is in the seventh case? Achi. Ach is in the seventh case. So ach being in the seventh case is achi. Whatever precedes a vowel, that is the sthani. And whatever will that sthani be, that will be one of the ik, e, u, ri, ru. So ikara, ukara, rukara or likara, which precedes any vowel immediately, that will become a sthani and will take yanadesha. So the next sutra says tasmadityuttarasya nirdishtat. So nirdishtat, there is an anurutti, tasmadityuttarasya. So tasmat panchami. This panchami shows that tasmat. So again iti, iti is there, so it is like quoting. So tasmat, kasmat. So tasmat is whatever is in the panchami. That tat will be whatever is in the panchami in the sutra, and thereby that will cause whatever follows. Uttarasya, uttara will become the sthani. What follows will be the sthani. Digyoge panchami. So panchami nirdeshena vidhiyamanam karyam varnantarena avivehatasya parasya uttarasya nyeyam. Uttarasya has been explained in the vritti as parasya. Bodhyam nyeyam, it should be known as the karya will be for whatever follows immediately. Avyatasya, avyavatasya, avyavahitasya parasya. So whatever immediately follows, that will become the sthani. So what is said here is that this panchami, so panchami is tasmad iti uttarasya, this will identify the sthani in the sixth case. Either if you have sixth case, well and good. If you don't have sixth case, then fifth case will identify, whatever is in fifth case will identify as to what follows is sthani. If you have saptami, then saptami will indicate whatever achi. For example, achi is in saptami. So achi will, this achi in saptami indicates that what precedes is the sthani. And that can be in sixth case in the sutra, it may not be there. And when you have fifth and seventh case, then fifth case will indicate. So what follows that is in the fifth case will become the sthani. So when you have fifth and sixth case missing, what will happen? Whatever is in the fifth case, X, let's say X is in fifth case, Akshara, and Y Akshara is in seventh case. And they, so what does it say, that whatever is immediately following is the sthani, says this fellow. X says that Y is the sthani, X being in fifth case. And Y being in seventh case, says that whatever is preceding is sthani. So what will happen? X is saying Y is sthani, Y is saying X is sthani. And you have sixth case missing, this won't be there. Then what will you do? So there another paribhasha says that panchami baliyan. So when ubhaya prapte panchami baliyan or something like that is there, that means that whatever is in the fifth case will be stronger than whatever is in the seventh case. So the X in fifth case identifies Y as sthani, and that will be stronger pramana than Y in seventh case indicating X as sthani. Therefore Y will end up as being sthani, because this will take precedence over the Y indicating X as sthani. So that's another thing we have to note here. That's an aside anyway. Okay, so So what happens? Now example is taken. Which is the example here? The example taken here is so example taken is Sudhi Upasya. Sudhi Upasya. So here in this example, Sudhi से शोभना धी यस्य और सुष्टु सुष्टु शोभना शोभना धी ही बुद्धि यस्य सह सुधी. सो दिस पर्सन इज हैविंग अ गुड इंटेलेक्ट, इज एन इंटेलिजेंट पर्सन. सो दैट इज सेड बाय सुधी. सो उपास्य, सो हैविंग डन सम उपासना, वॉट एवर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द सेंटेंस देर, बट इन द वाक्य दीज वर्ड्स हैव बीन प्रोनाउंस्ड टुगेदर, सुधी एंड उपास्य. सो उपास्य, लेट्स से उपास्य विष्णु उपास्य किमपि भवतु, विष्णु उपास्य और समथिंग लाइक दैट इज अ सेंटेंस, लेट्स से. सो हाउ डू यू से दैट? सुधी उपास्य विष्णु, एंड दैट इज हाउ द कंस्ट्रक्ट इज. व्हाट विल हैपन? ईकार एंड उपास्य शब्द उकार, ईकार इज इक अंतर्गत, ई ऊरीलु ई इज ह्रस्व दीर्घ प्लुत, ऑल दी 18 भेदाज आर कवर्ड बाय ई हियर, ई ऊरीलु. And upasya here is what? Ach. So upasya ukara is an ach, ach, ach antargata, it's a vowel. So now you have achi pare, achi ukare pare, ikaha ikarasya sthane yan adesha bhavati. So ikara is sthani because saptami is identifying this ach, achi, achi pare, ukare pare. So ukara is after. How do you know this ukara? Because ukara is parasaptami here, identified by ach, achi. In the sutra iko yanachi, this achi, achi ukare pare will be the artha there. This ukara is an ach, therefore ach ukara which follows, the vowel u which follows, follows what? Immediately preceding is ikara. So follows an ik which is immediately preceding it, then that ik will become the sthani. So ikasthane यण आदेश भवति मीन्स इकः ईकारस्य स्थाने यण आदेश भवति, देयर बाय दिस ईकार विल टेक आदेश, विच आदेश? यण, यवर अल. सो नाउ विच अमोंग यकार वकार रेफ एंड लकार शुड बी द आदेश? सो देयर स्थाने अंतरतमत्वम इज एक्सपेक्टेड, सो देयर फॉर दैट सूत्र इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द लघुकार विथ स्थाने अंतरतम, दैट सूत्र. So then sthane antartama, what is the meaning of sthane antartama? Sthana means prasanga. So sthane sati saptami, sthane sati, meaning prasange sthati. When such a situation arises, what situation? This situation which is said that sthani, when there are multiple possibilities in sthani, then sadrushatama is the meaning of antartama in the sutra. Antartama sadrushatama, tamak pratyaya is used, so that which is in the superlative, which is the proximate, most proximate to what? Sadrusha means similarity. In similarity, it is most proximate to the sthani, meaning the adesha yavarala, whichever among yavarala is the most proximate to ikara in sudhi, that will be the adesha. Antartama adesha syat. So you should look for similarity and the most proximate similarity. So what is this similarity? Sthanatah, arthatah, gunatah, pramanatah. These are the four ways there can be similarity identified between any two letters. So sthanatah is where the sound originates. So that is the sthana. That is the first thing that you should look for. If the sthana is matching and only one of the adeshas is matching the sthana of the sthani, then that is sufficient enough, you can go ahead with the replacement. If there are more letters which have the same sthana in the adesha as the sthani, then you have to look for other things such as artha, guna, pramana. But artha and pramana is matra, of course. Artha may or may not be there. These are just antartamatyam mentioned as to similarity, how is to be identified generally. But then arthata, what is the artha of a letter here? It makes no sense. So in such grammatical constructs or vidhis, there won't be any arthatah similarity. So you'll have gunata similarity. What is guna? Guna is prayatna. We have seen bahya and abhyantara prayatna. So in that, first you have to look at abhyantara similarity, and then bahya prayatna also can be seen. If the abhyantara prayatna does not गिव यू अ सिंगल आदेशा फॉर स्थानी, देन इफ नॉट दैट देन यू कैन गो फॉर मात्रा ऑल्सो. मात्रा प्रमाणता इज मात्रा, वॉट इज द ड्यूरेशन लेंथ ऑफ प्रोनाउंसिएशन. सो बाई दिस बट हियर स्थानतः यू विल सी दैट यकार इन सुधी उपास ईकार इज तालव्य. सो दिस ईकार इज तालव्य एंड देन दिस ईकार इज तालव्य एंड उकार इज ऑल्सो तालव्य. उकार इज एक्चुअली ओष्ट तालु, ओष्ट तालु, देयरफॉर तालु इज देयर. ओष्ट्य इज एडिशनल बट तालु इज कॉमन बिटवीन द टू. वेर एज विथ यकार इफ यू लुक एट वकार, वकार इज दंतोष्ट्य, सो देर इज नो तालु देर एट ऑल, इट इज नॉट हैविंग अंतर्तमत्व. इफ यू लुक एट रेफा, रेफा इज मूर्धन्य, इट डज नॉट हैव तालव्य प्रोनाउंसिएशन, देर फोर इट इज नॉट प्रॉक्सिमेट टू ई कार विच इज द स्थानी. एंड देन यू लुक एट लकार, लकार इज एनी वे दंत्य, सो देर इज नो तालव्य स्थान अंतर्तमत्व. सो स्थान अंतर्तमत्व इज बिटवीन ई कार एंड यकार, देर फोर दिस ई कार विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय यकार. सो वंस दैट हैपन्स यू विल गेट दिस कंसेप्ट एज सुधि ई कार विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय यकार. सो यू गॉट सुध्य, सुध्य उपास्य इति जाते. इति जाते मीन्स वेन यू हैव अटेन्ड दिस फॉर्म ऑफ सुधि उपास्य एज सुध्युपास्य. सो इफ यू प्रोनाउंस इट टुगेदर यू विल गेट सुध्युपास्य. For all practical purposes, the sandhi is over, but there is a vibhasha. There can be doubling of this dhakara, which is by anachicha. So therefore, that sutra is introduced as to an optional form is there. So next sutra comes up, anachicha. Anachicha kim? Achaha yaraha dve va syat. So anachicha, anachicha what? Anachi is saptami. So if you look at anachi is saptami, anachicha. And then anuvritti from the earlier sutra is achaha dve. Achaha, achaha is panchami. Yaraha dve syat. Achaha paraha. So if you look here, you have an example of panchami being there, saptami being there, and shashti being there. In the sutra only saptami is there. This is saptami, you have to identify whatever precedes immediately is the sthani. So what precedes immediately anachicha? When an ach is not following. So in sudhi, sudhyupasya, sudhyupasya iti prapte, iti jate. So sudhyupasya, upasya iti jate. Here what is anach, non-ach? Na-ach iti anach. So anachi pare, meaning when a non-vowel is following. What is a non-vowel here? A consonant. Where is a consonant following? So in this sudhyupasya, the consonant ikara has been replaced. That time, earlier to this replacement, ikara was followed by ukara. Dhakara was followed by ikara. So dhakara is followed by ach. Now, yakara is preceded by dhakara. Dhakara is followed by yakara. This yakara is anach, non-ach. Therefore, anachicha, when yakara, which is a non-vowel, when that is following what? So here you see, following what? Yar. So yar, yar is except for ha, then shasasar hal. So therefore except for hakara, any consonant except for hakara, when that is preceding immediately. This panchami is not preceding immediately, achaha. So achaha after an ach. So what is the situation? That you should have a yar, you should have a yar letter, which meaning what? A consonant which is not, this yar is what? Consonant, any consonant except hakara. So except hakara, if any consonant is sandwiched between an ach and an unach, so immediately preceded by a vowel and immediately followed by a consonant, non-vowel, consonant, then this yar, yaraha dve syat, then this yar will be doubled. So this, which is this yar here? So here you look at this yar is what? Dhakara. Sudhya upasya. So this yakara is anach. So this fellow is anach. Anach. Let me see if that is mentioned. later here we will see, it will have been mentioned here. So here you have what, this yakara is anach, non-ach, and this dhakara is preceded by ukara. So this ukara is what, this ukara is ach. And then between an ach and anach, what is sandwiched is this dhakara. This dhakara happens to be what, yar. So optionally this dhakara can be doubled, so you can have sudyupasya or you can have sudyupasya, sudyupasya. So that is the adesha. So this dhakara here, this is vibhasha. Optionally va means vibhasha, optionally you can have this doubling of dhakara. Iti dhakarasya dvitvena sudyupasya iti jate. So you can have sudyupasya or sudyupasya. So by doubling you can pronounce it in this manner optionally. Iti jate, when this form is there, then what happens now, next sutra is introduced, which is jhalam jas jashi. So here what is done is that before that there is some this anach, there is some explanation for nanj. So I'll skip this, I'll just mention what is important here right now to know. So there are two types of pratishedas. By negation, by nanj, when you say anach ityadi, there is a paryudasa pratisheda and prasajya pratisheda. What is important here is that there are, paryudasa is sadrgrahi, this it brings in other members of the same jati, whereas this is nishedakrut. Prasajya pratisheda meaning it just negates. So where is the nanj anvaya, that is important. So look at an example, in abrahmanam anaya, when you say abrahmanam anaya, so what is the nanj? If this nanj akara here is what, nanj, nanj akara, so what is the meaning of abrahmanam anaya? There this na nanj, where will this nanj have anvaya? Uttar padena sah nanj. So the nanj is with brahmana, brahmana shabda abrahmana anaya. So videhe pradhanyam, there videhe pradhanyam, what happens is that anaya, when you saying anaya, you bring someone. If you don't get brahmana, then bring a non brahmana, one who is closest to a brahmana, bring a kshatriya. That is the meaning there, abrahmana anaya, brahmana is not available. If by any chance brahmana is not available, please bring a kshatriya. That is the meaning there. So there videhe pradhanyam, the vidhi meaning anaya, you have to bring someone, meaning a non brahmana is to be brought. There is the vidhi is to bring, there is no negation there. So abrahmana is not negating a brahmana, it is not that don't bring a brahmana, it means bring someone. So that is the vidhi, you bring someone. Whereas when there is a pratisheda pradhanyam, meaning in prasajya pratisheda, the negation is nishedakrut. Pratisheda is pradhana, then kriya will take nanj. The anvaya of nanj will be with kriya. So it will mean that brahmanam na anaya, do not bring a brahmana. Then what will you say? Brahmanam na anaya, do not bring a brahmana. Because this na has an anvaya with anaya kriya. Kriya saha nanj. Whereas earlier what? Uttar padena sananj. Here kriya sananj. Then when you say na with a kriya, then that kriya says what? Do not do this. So if the bringing is a kriya, then do not bring. Whereas if uttarapada is taking nanj, then the kriya will take pradhanya. Kriya meaning has to be held, it is not negated. The kriya is not negated, therefore ane means you bring. So vidhi has to be followed. You bring somebody who is close to a brahmana. So that is how nanj has to be seen here. Here however, anachi cha, when you look at anachi, it conveys what? Prasajya pratisheda. So this anachi cha, in this anachi, prasajya pratisheda is there. What is that? Prasajya pratisheda is nishedakrut and then kriya as a nanj. Therefore, what does it do? Anachi, the reason for anachi to be taken as prasajya pratisheda is to bring avasana, meaning the absence of any letter. What does it mean? Anachi, anachi pare. What does it mean? It means that there should be no avasana. Anachi pare means when there is no avasana. सो द एब्सेंस ऑफ सो द रीजन फॉर अनची टेकन एज सॉरी अनची अनची परे इज टू ब्रिंग अवसाना. सो ब्रिंग द एब्सेंस ऑफ लेटर यूजली फाउंड एट द एंड ऑफ अ सेंटेंस. अवसाना इज अ पॉज. सो वॉट इज सेइंग दैट इफ इट हैड बीन टेकन एज पर्युदास प्रतिषेध अनची देन बींग सद्रग्राही इट वुड ब्रिंग हल. सो सजातीय विच इज वॉट अनची सजातीय. So now we look at this, there is a, if it was a case then it would have been Hali. So there is some explanation given as to why it is this Pratisheda or that kind of a Pratisheda. So I don't want to go into details because how this is applicable across each sutra where there is a negation, that has to be seen in that sutra vritti. So here just what is important is how it is applied. Instead of that, just look at this. There are two types of Pratishedas. One is with the Kriya, the other is not with the Kriya. So one is with the विधि विधि एज प्राधान्य. सो सो इट कुड हैव बीन सेड हली. सो व्हाट इज सेड इज दैट इफ एट ऑल इट मेंट सजातीय देन अनच वुड हैव बीन वुडंट हैव बीन सेड हल वुड हैव बीन सेड. इट वुड हैव हल मीनिंग इंस्टेड ऑफ अनची हली वुड हैव बीन सेड. एंड इफ यू से हली इट विल कंज्यूम लेस लेटर्स. सो व्हाई डिड द सूत्रकार डिड नॉट कंज्यूम लेस लेटर्स वेयर सूत्रास हैव टू बी एज शॉर्ट एज पॉसिबल एंड व्हेन यू सेव इवन हाफ अ मात्रा it is like a putra janma celebration. So vyakaranas, if the sutra, in sutra if you save even half a matra, then there is a celebration as though a son is born, putra is born. So that kind of a sutrakara has used anachi instead of hali. Therefore if had it mean meant sadrusha sadrusha grahi and thereby paryudasa pratisheda, then he would have used hali. So with that logic it is said that it is not Sadirgrahi, he would have said Hali. He didn't mean Hali, he just said Anachi. So what that means is that so to bring Avasana, meaning what here in our Sudhi Upasya this Avasana is there between Sudhi. Here you look at this Sudhi and Sudhiya and then Anachi Yakara this. So he basically it will finally end up with hal itself. The meaning will be hal, but he didn't say hali. So therefore the prasajya pratisheda is taken and still you land on the hal meaning. He would have said hal sajati hal, but he didn't say hal. So thereby you have to take this prasajya pratisheda and land on the meaning. So those who are interested can read this and see if you know there is more sense out of it which benefits. Here personally I don't see any benefit here in looking at this pratisheda, but this has to be known in vyakarana. There are two types of nan which are paryudasa and prasajya. So that's the only reason I am covering in a recap. In a sutra proper we'll see what applies and all that, but all these 330 sutras I am told are covered, and we are just trying to you know get through some 10 odd classes to 10-15 classes so that we can land there. The next sutra is jhalam jhalam jash jashi. It is a vidhi sutra. So you can see in the bracket earlier it is said whether it is a paribhasha sutra or a vidhi sutra. It's a vidhi sutra. It is giving a proper vidhi as to what has to be done, whether it is an adesha or agama, something like that. So here jashi pare jhalam jash jhalam shashti. So sthani jash is the adesha. When jashi pare parasaptami there is no anuvritti. So the jhal is replaced by jash. Jash is third of the class, varga tritiya. Jhal is starting with the fourth of the class, jhavai till hal. So all the 4, 3, 2, 1, fourth of varga chaturtha tritiya dvitiya prathama and then shashasa and ha hakara. So all of those when they are followed by jash, what is jash? Jash is varga chaturtha varga tritiya because jabagada dash. Then what they will take varga tritiya adesha. So this is a very common sandhi which is there in jhalam jash. Padanta sandhi is also there. There is another sutra, but something else has gone in between. Therefore this jhalam jash jashi pare brings in, and whatever change has taken place, that is to without padanta sandhi, what has what change has not taken place, or some change has taken place where this jatvam has been change, then it is brought back to jastum with another jash adesha sutra. The first is jhalam jasho ante. So that sandhi will occur almost for everything, but ante shabda is there because of that only in padanta there will be the such a jash adesha, varga tritiya adesha. That adesha is important, it is needed even when it is not at the अंत ऑफ द पदा वेन इन बिटवीन द पदा ऑल्सो वेन वर्ग चतुर्थ और वर्ग तृतीया फॉलोज देयर फोर दिस आदेश जस्ट इज ब्रॉट बैक अगेन इन द 8453 सूत्र. सो वॉट हैपन्स हियर. सो ये लघु वृत्तिकार से स्पष्टम, नथिंग टू एक्सप्लेन देयर, स्पष्टम. सो ये सी हियर जस्ट इज थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास एंड हियर यू हैव थर्ड एंड फोर्थ ऑफ द क्लास एज दी वॉट. सो आदेश इज थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास एंड जस्ट इज थर्ड फोर्थ ऑफ द क्लास विच इज फॉलोइंग एंड स्थानी इज वॉट. स्थानी इज फोर्थ थर्ड सेकेंड फर्स्ट ऑफ द क्लास एंड शशस हकार. ऑल दीज आर पार्ट ऑफ इट. वॉट रियली ऑकर्स वी हैव टू सी इन एग्जाम्पल्स. सो हियर वॉट वी हैव लैंडेड विथ सुध्युपास्य. सो दिस इज वन फॉर्म और वी हैव गॉट सेकेंड फॉर्म एज सुध्य धकारा डब्लिंग. नाउ दिस झलाम जशी सेज दैट वेन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ संधि हैज टेकन प्लेस देन वॉट विल हैपन. दिस धकारा सॉरी धकारा धकारा विच हैज डबल्ड, इफ इट हैज डबल्ड, सी इफ दिस इज द फॉर्म सुध्युपास इज फाइन. इफ यू हैव टेकन द विभाषा ऑफ अनचिच, अनचिच वॉट यरह अचह यरह द्वे, सो देयर बाय धकारा इज डबल्ड. नाउ दिस धकारा बीइंग डबल्ड दिस झलाम जस्ट जशी इज इन्वोक्ड. दिस धकारा विच जिस धकारा इज वॉट इज झश, मीनिंग झ भ घ ढ ध. सो दैट झवई घ ढश इन दैट सूत्र दिस धकारा इज देयर. सो इट्स फोर्थ ऑफ द क्लास वर्ग चतुर्थ. सो इट इज झश. सो झशी परे. सो वॉट एवर प्रिसीड्स दिस वॉट शुड दैट बी, दैट शुड बी अ झल. सो दिस इज अ झल. वॉट इज अ झश इज डेफिनेटली अ झल. झल इज ब्रॉडर देन झश, देयर फोर दिस इज झल. सो दिस झल विच इज प्रिसीडिंग इमीडिएटली प्रिसीडिंग झश दैट विल टेक झश आदेश. सो दिस धकारा विच फोर विच इज द फोर्थ ऑफ द क्लास दैट विल बिकम वॉट थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास. सो थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास विल बी द आदेश. सो दिस धकारा विल बिकम धकारा. So there is a dakara adesha. So this fourth of the class jhal is replaced by third of the class jash when fourth of the class jash dakara is immediately following. Thereby what has happened is that you will get sudhi upasya, sudhyupasya. This yakara sudhyupasya. The earlier dakara, dakara will become dakara. It will become the earlier mahaprana dhakara will become alpaprana dhakara. Now there is another issue, another issue dealt with as to what sudhyupasya. You got this form sudhyupasya. Basically how will you be writing it? Generally you will writing it with a sandhi taking place. You will say sudhyupasya, you will pronounce it that way and you will write for some reason why. Yeah. So you will write it together. Sorry. There will be dakara and this dakara will become jupasya. So sudjupasya. Lyabanta pada, let's consider it's a lyabanta pada. Supasya. Having done upasana. Of Vishnu. So Sudhyupasya, you will pronounce it this way, Sudhyupasya. Now what is said is that here this is how you pronounce, but what has happened? Sudhya, there is a Sudhya Yakara, this is a different pada. Although you will pronounce it in this manner without any avasana in between, there is an avasana here. There is an avasana with Sudhya Upasya, but had there been an avasana, then this Ukara wouldn't have caused sandhi at all. So there is no, although you see gaps when they are written, but sandhi samhitayam vishe initially ikoyanachi samhitayam vishe only. So this ukara is in sandhi with this ikara which was there earlier. It is in sandhi, so there is no avasana in between, but they are still two padas. There is a sandhi between two padas, but they are still two padas. So now this yakara which has been a replacement is in conjunct with this dhakara and in conjunct with this dakara also. सो दकार धकार यकार कंजंक्ट इज देयर विच इज एट द एंड ऑफ द पद एंड इन व्याकरण व्हाट इज द रूल एट द एंड ऑफ द पद देयर कैनॉट बी अ कंजंक्ट सो दिस यकारा शुड हैव गॉन अवे धकारा शुड हैव गॉन अवे एंड ओनली दकारा वुड रिमेन दिस इज वॉट वुड हैव हैपेंड इफ वी नो ओनली अ रूल दैट पदांत conjunct will have elision thereby something else is prapta to actually preserve this so what I said is that he brings in first vidhi sutra by which this lopa is prapta padanta so that sutra is mentioned here as what sanyogantasya lopaha padasya is the anuvritti so sanyogantasya lopa sanyogantasya padasya meaning padantasya sanyogasya संयोगांतस्य पदस्य मीन संयोग विच इज एट द अंत ऑफ द पद पदांत संयोगस्य लोपः स्यात् सो संयोगांतम यत् पदम तदंतस्य लोपः स्यात् सो संयोगांतम यत् पदम दैट पद विच इज हैविंग अ संयोग एट इट्स अंत संयोग अंतेस्य पदस्य तत् पदम संयोगांतम पदम सो दैट पदा विच हैज अ संयोग कंजंक्ट एट इट्स एंड इज अ संयोगांत पद तदंतस्य मीन तादृश पदांतस्य तादृक पदांतस्य मीन्स व्हाट दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पदा अंत विच इज एट द एंड ऑफ द पदा दैट पदांत एट एंड ऑफ द पदा वेर देर इज अ संयोग तस्य लोपः स्यात् सो द लास्ट एट द एंड ऑफ द पदा संयोग विच एंड्स विद अ संयोग कंजंक्ट दैट विल हैव अ लोप By we have seen this tadanta tadanta vidhi and tadadi vidhi. So tadanta vidhi will cause a sanyogantasya padasya sthane lopaha. That would thereby thus the whole pada gets elided. First of all, whole pada padasya sthane. Or if you know letter by letter also can be dropped. Thereby these letters at least have to be preserved. Pada nobody will make a pada lopa. But letters can be dropped, conjunct cannot survive, therefore you keep on dropping the last letter as long as a conjunct is broken. So at least that would have happened. Now what happens is that this sanyo padasya lopa or sanyogasya lopa, whatever has taken place, neither of them are ishta. What is ishta is to retain them. Thereby there is a preservation sutra which is paribhasha sutra. So another paribhasha sutra which is alontyasya. Alontyasya. Now, first of all, padasya. This pada will get lopa by this sutra sanyogantasya lopa. But we have seen that whatever is the vidhi that will apply to the last letter of the pada, not the entire pada. So, by this sutra, the pada should be elided. That's why the vritti is saying tadantasya lopa, and there the question raised by I think the explanation in the book. So thereby pada will be elided. Yeah, here. So here this is the vritti. I mean this is not the laghu vritti, but the whole pada gets elided is an explanation if we didn't know tadanta vidhi. So this is an explanation by Medhaji in the book, but this is not prapta. Why? Because there is a next sutra, paribhasha sutra, which is alontyasya. Whatever is the vidhi, where it is a vidhi for a letter. So what happens is that it will apply to a letter. Shashti nirdishtasya antyasya alaha adeshasya. The adesha is for an al, a single letter, not the entire pada. Therefore, I said that sudhya, if you can pronounce as sudhya with a for pronunciation only, sudhya, upasya, that yakara is in conjunct with a dhakara, which is in conjunct with a preceding dhakara. So the entire pada will not go, but still the last letter yakara will go away. Yakara will go away, then dhakara will go away because it is also still in conjunct with dhakara. So you have in sudhi, you have sud, dha and yakara. So these two are in conjunct. So this yakara will be added. Then these two will still be in conjunct. So this dhakara will be added. So you will be left with sud. This is wrong. Why? Because having spent so much of time on trying to apply yana sandhi, एंड देन यू कीप ऑन इलाइडिंग वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ अप्लाइंग यन एंड अनचिच ऑल्सो एंड देन झलाम जशी ऑल्सो एंड देन यू से फाइनली ऑल दीज थ्री विच आर मॉडिफिकेशन ऑल ऑफ देम आर ड्रॉप ओनली अनचिच विल नॉट अनचिच बट देन झलाम जशी विल हैव कॉज जस्टोम दैट्स ऑल यू आर गेटिंग इन सुधी धकार इकारा इज गॉन यकारा विच वॉज रिप्लेस्ड दैट इज गॉन धकारा विच वॉज हैज कम इन बाय डबलिंग दैट इज गॉन एंड देन दिस धकारा विच सर्वाइव बाय डबलिंग दैट धकारा हैज टेकन जश आदेश एंड जस्तोम इट हैज बिकम धकारा सो वॉट हैव यू अचीव्ड सो मच ऑफ द्राविड प्राणायाम एंड देन ऑल ऑफ दिस इज गॉन सो इट मेक्स नो सेंस सूत्राज आर नेवर फ्यूटाइल सूत्राज आर आई मीन दे आर वेदवत सो सूत्राज आर कंसिडर्ड लाइक वेदास दैट्स वाई सूत्रा लिसनिंग टू सूत्राज ऑल्सो गिवज पुण्य भगवान महाभाष्यकार सेज दैट इवन लिसनिंग टू व्याकरण सूत्राज गिवज पुण्य सो वेदवत सूत्राज आर वेदवत छंदोवत सो छंदोवत दे आर लाइक लाइक वेदास देर फोर दे आर फ्लॉलेस एंड बींग फ्लॉलेस यू कैनॉट हैव सूत्राज विच आर फ्यूटाइल एंड ब्रिंग इन सो मच ऑफ एफर्ट सो मच ऑफ चेंजेस एंड ऑल ऑफ देम आर रिलाइडेड सो वॉट इज डन हियर इज दैट दी इति यलोपे प्राप्ते इति यलोपे प्राप्ते सती दिस यकार लोप इज प्राप्त विच यकार दिस यकार विच इज इन कॉन्जंक्ट एट द एंड फर्स्ट दिस इज प्राप्त देन सेकेंड धकार विल ऑल्सो भी प्राप्त इफ यकार गोज अवे बट यकार इज प्रोटेक्टेड हाउ इति यलोपे प्राप्ते सती देन वार्तिका देर इज अ वार्तिका अंडर दिस सूत्र यण प्रतिषेध्यो प्रतिषेधो वाच्य यण प्रतिषेधो वाच्य एट द एंड ऑफ द पद इफ देर इज अ कॉन्जंक्ट कॉन्सोनेंट यू इलाइड ऑल दैट फेयर नाफ बट द वार्तिका सेज दैट यू प्रोटेक्ट द कॉन्जंक्ट कॉन्सोनेंट लेटर एट द एंड ऑफ द पद विच हैज कम बाय यण संधि अदरवाइज यण संधि विल हैव गॉन वेस्ट will go waste therefore what you protect that so yanah pratishedha vachya yanah shashti pratishedha vachya the what pratishedha pratishedha sanyoga antasya lopah iti ya vidhi tasya pratishedha vachya so there should be the yan lopa yan krita adesha whatever is there tasya pratishedha that should be negated tasya लोपस्य प्रतिषेध सो वाच्य शुड हैव बीन सेड एंड इट विल बी रिवील्ड बाय सम अदर सूत्र बाय प्रोटेक्टिंग बाय द फॉर्म विल बी शोन वेयर बाय इट इज प्रोटेक्टेड सो वार्तिका इज ब्रिंगिंग अबाउट ओनली दैट विच इज देयर इन द सूत्रास इट विल नॉट बी विजिबल टू अस हू हैव नो ओनली वन और टू सूत्रास हियर एंड देयर बट दोज हू नो द एंटायर अष्टाध्यायी 4000 सूत्रास दे विल नो हाउ दिस वार्तिका हैज कम अबाउट बिकॉज विदाउट द वार्तिका ऑल्सो द सेम मीनिंग विल कम फ्रॉम द सूत्र बिकॉज सूत्रास आर फ्लॉलेस So thereby yakara is protected, thereby dhakara will become protected and you get sudyupasya, varna sammaline. So this is the final form, one or sudyupasya, meaning dhitva bhava pakshi, because anachi is optional. So you'll have two forms, this is one form and this is the second form. This is the complete derivation of sudyupasya with yana sandhi and other paribhashika sutras. This tippani has to be. And then the other examples are madhari tras etc. So with yan other yava so yakara is covered then madhari hi dhatraunshah lakruti hi these are other examples given to cover yan sandhi. The next sandhi sutra covered is echo yavayavah echo yavayavah. So some people pronounce this sutra for better understanding they say but sutras are not to be split there should be no split in the sutra so echo ayavayavaha is the pronunciation by some that is not a sadhu pronunciation for understanding it is given because it is difficult for the acharya to teach and for the shishyas to understand therefore such pronunciation is done but when you're chanting it should be echo yavayavaha for punya labha echo yavayavaha then when you split it you will get echaha shashti sthani एचः षष्टिस्थानी एंड देन अय औ आय आव दीज आर दि फोर आदेश इन प्लुलर इट विल बिकम लाइक मरुत मरुतौ मरुतः, सो मरुतः इज प्लूरल ऑफ मरुत शब्द. सिमिलरली अयवायाव इज द प्रातिपदिक, अयवायावः इज द प्लूरल बिकॉज देर आर फोर आदेशास. सो अय औ आय आव एंड हियर एच इज वॉट ए ओ ऐ औ. सो ए ओ ऐ औ अची परे वेन दे आर इन डायरेक्ट इमीडिएट संधि विथ अच एकार ओकार इत्यादि विथ एनी वॉवेल देन संहितायां विषय वेन देर हैव संधि देन एच विल बिकम स्थानी एंड एच विल बी रिप्लेस बाय ऐ औ आय आव रिस्पेक्टिवली. हाउ डू यू नो रिस्पेक्टिवली? दैट इज इन नेक्स्ट सूत्र. सो एच क्रमात् अय औ आय आव एते अयवायावः स्युः अचि परे. क्रमात् इज मेंशन्ड. हाउ डू यू गेट दिस क्रमात्? केन प्रमाणेन? सो हियर इफ यू लुक एट इट दिस परिभाषा सूत्र यथा संख्यम अनुदेश समानम समानाम. सो यथा संख्यम अनुदेशः समानाम. सो एच इज आल्सो फोर, अय औ आय आव आर आल्सो फोर, देयरफोर रिस्पेक्टिवली देयर इज अ रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ ईच. So A will take ay adesha, O will take av adesha, I will take ay adesha and O will take av adesha when each of these A, O, I, O are followed immediately by ach. So here therefore yatha sankhyam anudesha samana is brought by lagukara because without that you don't know which will be the adesha for what. So here samasambandhi samana means samasambandhi vidhihi, anudesha means vidhihi. यथासंख्यम स्यात्, यथासंख्यम मीन्स रिस्पेक्टिवली. एज देर आर फोर प्रिसीडिंग इन दी स्थानी एंड फोर फॉलोइंग इन दी आदेशा, देर फोर दे विल बी वन ऑन वन रिस्पेक्टिवली आदेश. सो सो वेन यू हैव एन एग्जाम्पल, नाउ हियर एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन एज वॉट, हरि प्लस ने. वॉट इज हरि प्लस ने? सो एग्जाम्पल हर ए विष्णवे नायक पावक, दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ लघुकारा. सो हर ए इज टेकन फॉर एनालिसिस फर्स्ट. हरी, हरी प्लस चतुर्थी एक वचन प्रत्यय. सो दिस चतुर्थी एक वचन प्रत्यय हैपन्स टू बी ज्ञे. सु औजस अमौजस टाभ्याम भिस् ज्ञेभ्याम भ्य. सो ज्ञे इज चतुर्थी एक वचन प्रत्यय, हर ए नमः. सो हाउ डू गेट हर ए फ्रॉम हरी प्लस फोर्थ केस सिंगुलर प्रत्यय? सो हरी इज इकारांत पुल्लिंग शब्द, यू एड ए टू इट. इज एन एग्जाम्पल गिवन. So ekara you add this nyakara is it. How is nyakara it? So there is a anubandha lopa, it is called anubandha lopa. So what happens, nyakara is ka varga antargata. So lashakvat tadite lakara ku ka kha ga ga nya nya. So nyakara which is in an atadhita pratyaya where adi शफ प्रत्यस्य, प्रत्यस्य आदि, आदिर निटुडव, दैट आदि फ्रॉम आदिर निटुडव देन शफ प्रत्यस्य विल ब्रिंग इन प्रत्यस्य एज अनुवृत्ति हियर एंड देन यू विल हैव लशक्वत तद्धिते. सो अतद्धिते प्रत्यय परे व्हेन नॉट प्रत्यय परे व्हेन द प्रत्यय इज इन द प्रत्यय विच इज व्हाट एन उपदेश, उपदेश इन उपदेश एट द बिगिन ऑफ द प्रत्यय विच इज नॉन तद्धिता. सो सुप्रत्यय इज नॉन तद्धिता, इट इज अ प्रत्यय, इट इज एट द आदि ञकार विच इज क वर्ग अंतर्गत कु लश कु, देर बाय दिस ककार विल अंडर गो लोप बाय बिकमिंग इत, इट्स इत इत इतः तस्य इतः लोप इत स्यात् एंड देन इतः लोप देन ए विल रिमेन देन हरि प्लस ए. नाउ दिस इकार इज वॉट, दिस इकार इज यू हैव this ikara, so here nothing but ikara is, ikara will take guna. So there here niti, there is sutra guna. So guna, ikara will take guna. Guna for ikara is ekara. So so much is there, other sutras we are not focused on. So you will have ekara and ekara, hare and ekara. This is ikara becoming ekara by guna. So this is our example, meaning the step example is this. This is our example as to what will happen here. Ekara which is an H, this Ekara is an H and this A is an Ach. So Achi Pare, when Ekara is followed by Ach, then what will happen, this Ekara will take ए औ आय आदेश। सो हियर ए इज द फर्स्ट फॉर ए, सो हरी हरे एकारा विल टेक एक हरे एकारा विल टेक ए आदेश। सो यूल गेट हरे विल बिकम हरे एंड हरे प्लस ए विल बिकम हरये, दैट इज द फॉर्म रूप सिद्धि हरये, जस्ट वर्ण मेलनम देयर। देन अदर एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन, आई विल नॉट गो थ्रू दोस एज रीकैप। देन येद विधिस्तदंतस्य, व्हाट वाज द लघुवृत्ति एट द एंड, हरे विष्णुये, दैट्स ऑल। सो एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन, आई नीड टू चेक वेदर देयर इज दिस वृत्ति लघुवृत्ति लाइक दैट, इज नॉट टेकन एनी एग्जाम्पल येट, आई एम सरप्राइज दैट दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स। सो हियर देन येन विधिस्तदंतस्य इज अ परिभाषा सूत्र, दिस इज ऑल्सो परिभाषा सूत्र, वॉट डज इट से, यू हैव सीन इज येन विधि तदंतस्य स्वस्य रूपस्य। सो वॉट डज इट से दैट वॉट एवर विधि एच, हाउ डू यू नो एच इज अ प्रत्याहार एंड वॉट डज इट स्टैंड फॉर। सो ही सेज दिस एच और इवन इक और यन, दे स्टैंड फॉर themselves till the end letter. So swasya, rupasya and what? Antasya cha. Yena vidhistad antasya, sorry. It stands for swaru, its own self and also for the anta. So padanta, so tadanta. Basically this is what? Yena vidhistad antasya, then that vidhi will be applicable to what? What will be the vidhi for? Is it for whatever is said? So here स्व स्व मीन्स वॉट प्रातिपदिक, स्व इज प्रातिपदिक, एक्चुअली आई फॉरगॉट दैट दैट इन दी अर्लियर इनिशियल सूत्रज इट्स द एग्जाम्पल एंड दी 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 प्रत्याहार वॉज कवर्ड, देर फॉर दिस इकोयणची सिद्धि टुक प्लेस। बट नाउ वॉट इज सेड इज दैट दिस तदंत तदंत, देर इज अ विशेषण विशेष भाव, देर फोर विशेषणं तदंत संन्यासा स्वस्य च रूपस्य, विच वी सॉ एज तदंत विधि। सो व्हाट आई सेड इज दैट ए हे, एग्जाम्पल गिवन इज ए हे अज धातो प्रत्यय, आई डोंट वांट टू टेक दिस, इज देर अ लघुवृत्ति देर, देर इज नो लघु एग्जाम्पल देर, लेट द लघु एग्जाम्पल कम, वी लुक एट दैट। सो तदादि विधि एंड तदंत विधि आई एक्सप्लेन, सो देर इज फॉर तदंत विधि देर इज अ वार्तिका विच ब्रिंग्स इन दिस तदादि विधि, यस्मिन विधिस तदादो अलग्रहणे, सो यस्मिन विधिस तदादाव अलग्रहणे, सेज दैट वेन एवर देर इज अ आदेश, दैट आदेश इज एप्लीकेबल टू इट्स सेल्फ एज वेल एज टू इट्स अंत। सो इट कैन बी आदेश फॉर इट्स सेल्फ, but then if there is a visheshana then pada padasya, if it is there then padantasya will be the interpretation, meaning it will apply to the anta of the pada, and we have seen algrahan, there is only one letter which is replaced, which is at the end of the pada. Now with the tadadi vidhi we have seen that not only at the end, but if there is a saptami nirdesha, if the vidhi is given by a saptami, then the immediately preceding is the yasmin vidau यस्मिन विधिस तदादो अलग्रहणे। सो देन वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट बोथ पुट टुगेदर यू विल हैव विद परसप्तमी ऑल्सो एंड विद तस्माद तस्मादिति निर्दिष्टस्य परस्य, द परा विल टेक द आदेश, वेन सच अ सिनेरियो एग्जिस्ट देन वॉट विल टेक द आदेश विल नॉट बी एट द पद अंत, द लेटर शुड बी एट द बिगिनिंग बिकॉज स्थानी इज वॉट इज फॉलोइंग, सो वॉट इज इमीडिएटली फॉलोइंग दैट विल बिकम द स्थानी, then there this tadanta vidhi won't work, you will have tadadi vidhi. So that is this vartika as well, which says that tad adau, so yasmin algrahane sati vidhi karyam bhavati tadadau pare iti veditavyam. So this is what Medhaji's explanation for that. So this is for the vritti. Anyway, we have seen this as to whenever you have an adesha, that adesha is for whatever follows or whatever precedes immediately. If that is the scenario, then if it is for whatever immediately precedes, then the entire pada is preceding, but then whatever is preceding the that pada's end letter will take the adesha, that is by tadanta vidhi. And if whatever is following that is the sthani, then whatever is following, if it is a pada or whatever set of letters, the entire thing shouldn't be replaced, But there tadanta vidhi will also not be applicable because not the last letter should be replaced, but the first letter should be replaced. Therefore, tadadi vidhi. That's all these sutras mean. And then echo ayavayavaha, you see here, au. So this is actually, there's some other example taken here as to why this sutra is needed. And then another sutra that comes up is vanto yi pratyaya samhitayam echaha. So vantaha yi pratyaya samhitayam odautau by Vartika, or anumana is mentioned. So anumana is based on what? Based on sutras. No Vartika is needed. So Vartikas have also come up from that itself. From the sutra itself, somewhere in sutra you say something else happening, and in one sutra it is mentioned, then you have to reinterpret the understanding, and thereby you will see there is an exception to the rule which was stated. That rule is not, exception is not stated as a sutra, but in some formation of the word you see some sutras applying and you get a Rupa Siddhi which is an exception to the general rule which was stated in the sutra itself. Thereby by Anumana, that is the Anumana, and that Anumana will lead to a Vartika, has actually led to the Vartika. Therefore, without the Vartika, those who follow only Ashtadhyayi and nothing else, they'll say nothing else, Ashtadhyayi in Ashtadhyayi order as a purist, nothing else should be followed, no Laghu, no Kaumudi Granthas, nothing should be even looked at. They'll say that sutras by themselves are sufficient. And they may even say that Vartikas are not needed. If you go to Mahabhashya, Mahabhashya will take the Vartika and explain from the Sutra also, and therefore Sutras themselves bring about the Vartika. That is the Anumana there. Or you directly go to the Vartika because we do not have complete study of Sutras, we don't have retention of such Sutras with meaning. Therefore, we'll need some Kaumudi Prakriya Granthas to understand, and through that understanding, we'll need Vartikas also to explain what is happening. Otherwise, we would have said, oh, Sanyogantasya Lopa, Kimna Yilopasyat. Then you would have got some ridiculous form which is not Ishta. Therefore, we need help from the Vartika. Nonetheless, Vantaha Hi Pratyaya. So, there, what happens is this Vidhi Sutra, I am at odds because Yakarado Pratyaya Pare O Dautau Av Av Etau Staha. So, there, what is done is that Yakarado Pratyaya Pare. I would have liked to skip these sutras because they are not that important. These are what very few exceptions to. In the recap, I wouldn't have wanted to spend so much of time. But then, because there is no smooth flow, there are some odd examples picked, and there is no smooth flow which takes place in the Prakriya Grantha. If we are studying Kaumudi Granthas and we are looking for a recap, we should have a flow of a word which is being derived, and then the sutras are brought. Here that kind of a rule is not there right now because two Paribhashika sutras are to be introduced which are very, have very specific applications. So Vantav Yi Pratyaya, this Vanta is what? Vaha Ante Yasya Saha Vantaha. So Vanta means Vakara, this Vakara, not Vakara, Vakarat Akara Uccharanartha here. So Vakara is at the end. So what is said is that in Av and Av, so in Echo Ayavaya Vaha, Vanta is what? In these four Adeshas, so I Av, among these, this Av is there and Av is there. I and I are Yanta, but these two, I and Av and Av, are what? Vakara are at the end. So they are what? They are Vanta. They are having Vakara at the end. So that is meant here by Vanta. So it is needed Yakarado Pratyaya Pare O Dautau Av Av Etau Staha. So what is the meaning of the sutra here? Vanto Yi Pratyaya, Vantaha Yi Pratyaya Samhitayam O Dautau Vakaranta. So what you will get? A O I Au. So O and Au. Vanta Adeshas Av and Av are for what? Okara and Aukara. Therefore, by Anumana also you get that. Vanta. Vantaha Yi Pratyaya. When Yi Pratyaya, the letter Yakara in Parasaptami, Yi Pare, Yakare Pare. So what is the situation? This Okara and Aukara, when they are followed by Yakara. What Yakara? This Yakara, Yi Pratyaya, this I, av and a would have been the adesha if ach was following. Then this would have been the case, but yakara is not an ach. So it is extended, the rule is extended to, it's a vidhi sutra, but by extension you see when yakara is no, is a non-ach, achi pare was the earlier, echo yavayavaha, now vantaha yi pratyaya, this av and av adesha will take place only when okara ukara are preceding, yakara is following. So this yakara is a non-ach, therefore this sutra was needed, and echo yavayava, entirely echo yavayavaha wouldn't have applied, because when ekara and aikara are preceding, then this sutra won't work. So only vantaha, vantaha is adesha will be there. So the example for that is you look at it, what is go shabda. So you will get go shabda in taddita, in taddita goho vikaraha. So something which is go vikara, what is that? Gavya. So gavya is go vikara. How a cow eats some food and then it gives out gomaya, or it gives out milk, which is also govikara. So the one may argue that the vikara is of the grass that the cow has eaten, but once the grass is eaten, that grass is no longer grass, it has become part of the go, it, the gomata. So it is part of the cow itself. The grass that the cow has eaten, without the cow eating, the grass will not be converted to milk or cow dung. It will happen only when the cow eats it. Therefore, and in Upanishads we know, what is it? The Annamaya Kosha. The cow is what? Cow Kosha, the entire sharira of the cow is what? Annamaya. Modification of Annamayat Pratyaya. So it is a vikara of Anna. Similarly, the grass that the cow has eaten, the milk is the vikara, gavya. So all the gavya products, whatever the panchagavya you say, all the five products of the cow are vikara of the cow. That is why they are pujya. So it is not by that the grass is pujya, but grass that has been eaten by the cow and thrown out, or purified and given out as milk, all that is pujya. Gomutra is pujya. So that is the example here. Go plus you have nyas plus yat. So here you will get go, because this this entire thing is taddita, and krut taddita samasascha pratipadikam, thereby they will get pratipadika sanya. Having get what are pratipadika sanya, what will happen there? This nyas suplopa supodhatu pratipadikayoho, so there will be lopa, look, look syat, this nyas will be elided. So you will go plus yat. When you have go plus yat, takara will go away, halantyamit tasya lopa, so you will get go plus ya. When you have go plus ya situation, then this yakara adi, this ye pratyaye, vantaha ye pratyaye, when yakara is in a pratyaya and it is beginning with a ya, is a pratyaya in which yakara is at its adi. So ye pare, ye pratyaye pare go okarasya av iti adesha syat, and thereby you will get gakara, okara has become av, so you will get gav, gav plus ya, you will get gavya. So this is the gavyam. So finally the form will be gavyam. And the examples are also navataryam, navyam, etc. So that's the, then there is adhva parimane cha. So we will see this vartika if it is needed in the, we'll skip this. So we'll directly go to adenguna. So those who are want to look at it, then we'll go to the next sanya sutra, adenguna. Which is the guna is explained. Before going to guna sandhi, what is guna has to be explained. Therefore, this sutra comes up. We'll see in the next part. Now I already used highlight. Let me highlight anyway. So I'll highlight this by another color, maybe. Not sure how this works. Let it be. Okay, I'll. Use this as well as underline. So this is where we'll continue. Tavasane nataraja rajo nana dhadakkanava panchavaram uddhartu kama sanakadi siddhane tad vimarsheshu vasutra jalam. Namaste, dhanyavadam.